Hello, welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial shows how you, as a service person, can effectively use the Easy Starter to diagnose and troubleshoot faults. If a fault is detected, the device indicates this status via its red LED. Additionally, when you are online with the Easy Starter, the drive fault is highlighted in the status line. And the event number and event type of the fault are shown in the monitor panel. Let us switch to the tab for error diagnosis. On the diagnostic tab we find in summary all important status information. All parameters are read only in this tab, but if necessary, the suitable device commands can be used here. If an error has occurred, the device event monitor provides more detailed information to locate the cause of the trouble. Click the three-dot button next to the parameter. The error details dialog box shows in plain text the information of the current event number. 0x symbolizes a hexadecimal notation of the given value. 2009 contains information about the event type and location. 7303 is the unique identifier of the event or description text. If the error description is not clear, we can directly call the help about the error. In the help we find further tips to all possible event descriptions. For example, the help for our current error refers to the parameter 0x2C45. With the help of this parameter, it is possible to set the response of the device when the monitoring is triggered. Let us check the parameter setting. Before we switch to the settings, here still the remark, the event status shows that a reset is not possible. This means that the cause of the error is not fixed yet. A simple reset does not solve our issue. The event location is in the basic settings. Let's go there now. In the settings tab we can go directly to the event location or search for a corresponding dialog. Let us look for the parameter that we have previously found in the help. Now we are in the settings for the motor feedback. The relevant connections on the i950 are graphically illustrated here. Also we find here the searched parameter 2C45 for the error response of motor feedback. It makes sense to leave the setting on. What other information is available to us? Very helpful is always the integrated logbook function that contains a chronological list of all important events within the device. On opening, the Easy Starter reads out all events from the device once. The newest entry is located at the top with the highest number. Each new event is stored with a number increased by 1. If the reserved logbook memory buffer is full, the event with the smallest number will be replaced by the current event. The view can be refreshed at any time by clicking on this update button. For a better overview, the event location and the event type can be filtered in the logbook. When selecting two events by mouse click with simultaneously pressed Ctrl key, the time difference is displayed. This makes it easier to see whether repeated entries are related in time. In addition, the logbook can be exported so that the information is available for further processing. For example, if we want to contact support, the data are not stored on the SD card, but in the internal device memory. Finally, a note about the system time, which also marks the exact time of each event. If the current time is not displayed correctly, it is usually due to the selection of the time base. the default setting NTP expects a valid server address and internet access. Usually, the i950 device is offline or in best case connected to a server via a field bus. Manual entry is the remedy here. Let us switch back to the diagnosis. In the upper area, the diagnostics tab offers helpful dialogues. The communication button contains status information on the three interfaces and is structured similarly to the settings tab. Instead of taking a look, we go directly to the I/O dialog box. At a glance, we can see the status of the inputs and outputs, as well as the exact signal usage. In this technology application, the first digital input is used in parallel as a source for the reference switch for homing and as a touch probe input, for example for a position synchronization. The dialog box of the TA offers a similar view. Here, the essential parameters of the application are additionally shown in graphical form. The counter dialog contains various stress counters and time counters and allows feedback on the previous utilization of the components. Last, we go to the info. In addition to the type code, hardware and software version, the serial numbers of the installed components are visible at one glance. A very interesting function is located directly behind the corresponding serial number of the components. With one click, you can go directly to the Lenze information hub in the browser, assumed that internet access is available. Here you will find all available technical data and documents for the selected component. Alternatively, you can also submit a request to technical support or announce a repair order. Let us go back to the present error scenario. We still have the active fault status. The device event monitor shows the error on the motor feedback. The current motor temperature indicates an unrealistic value, maybe due to missing or wrong sensor signals. Reset is not possible, which we have seen before in the device event monitor. Let us check the connection on the device. Look, the feedback plug at slot A was not correctly fixed or has detached due to mechanical vibrations. The cause of the error has been eliminated. The event status shows that a reset is now possible. After resetting the error, we can enable the operation again. It is good to know that errors can be reset not only via the Easy Starter, but also by digital input or from the PLC application via the control word. Let us take another look to the monitor and the favorites, with which we always have the essential parameters in view. In the monitor panel, a maximum of 8 parameters per device can be shown simultaneously as display parameters. We have already shown the simple assignment via drag and drop several times in previous tutorials. The maximize and minimize buttons allow us to adjust the view. If we are in the machine far away from the computer screen, we can zoom out the value for clearer reading. Alternatively, it is possible to show the monitor of up to 5 devices at the same time. If the root directory of the online device list is selected, the monitor including the status line of the first 5 devices is visible. Well, here in the example we have only 4 devices. To monitor several devices at the same time, we hold down the control key on the keyboard and click on the desired device to select it. To deactivate multiple monitoring, click on one device without the control key. The monitor configuration is neither saved in Easy Starter nor in i950. Select one or more devices and click Export to save the current monitor configuration. If the monitor shows multiple devices, Easy Starter exports the monitor configuration for each selected device as a separate EPC file. To load saved monitor configuration, select one or more devices and click Import. It is possible to import same monitor configuration for several devices at the same time. If only one device is selected in the device list, favorites can be shown alternatively in the monitor area. The configuration can be done by drag and drop, just like with the monitor. In the favorite panel, we can monitor and change the value of a parameter. Alternatively, the favorites can also be configured in the parameter list. The writing pen opens the editing dialog. The available parameters we can add to the favorites are shown here on the left and can be filtered using the familiar selection fields. For multiple selection, we press the Shift key or Control key. The favorites can also be exported to a file via this editing dialog and easily reused in other devices. Only the first 8 of the maximum 50 possible parameters are visible in the favorites panel. Finally, the parameters selected as favorites are saved in the device. For working even more effectively, it is good to know that we can adjust the startup behavior of the Easy Starter. In the settings of the tool, different options can be set. In the default settings, the Easy Starter always starts with the welcome wizard and asks whether to add devices online or offline. When try to restore device list from previous session option is ticked, the Easy Starter keeps the device list in mind and tries to restore it at the next startup. This includes online devices, previously saved offline devices, connections between devices, and the selection in the device list. The option Fix the online device list is useful if the Easy Starter is permanently running on the same machine and no devices are added or removed. If the Easy Starter is used on different machines with several online devices, a prepared suitable connection list can be loaded automatically at startup. We can easily generate the connection list for each device or the complete online device list by export. Afterwards, we can use the created connection list by opening the Easy Starter with call parameters. At this point, we should refer to the example that we can find in the help. Either we start the Easy Starter via command line with the additional call parameters, or we adapt the sample program to our needs and connect to all devices on a machine with simple calls of a batch file. Remember that when starting from the command line or batch file, this call parameters take priority. This means we are ideally equipped to effectively use the Easy Starter for service and maintenance.